senior director with Deloitte is also with us on the show. Neetha, to talk about the kind of white-collar crime that we're seeing, is it that we have now more sophisticated tools to detect the kind of crime that is taking place, or is it that the number of cases are clearly on the rise?
I'll answer your second question first. If media headlines are any indication, we clearly see that the number of corporate frauds are increasing. Various surveys which have been carried out also indicate that the corporate frauds are on rise. Not only that, it also indicates that corporate frauds are expected to grow in future as well. Are there tools, sophisticated tools, which are available now to investigate corporate frauds? Answer to that is yes, there are. Today, technology is being used extensively by fraudsters in communication, in creating various documents which are used to perpetuate frauds, in communication like emails, and many a times the evidence is available in the digital form. To investigate these corporate frauds effectively and to preserve and present evidence effectively, various tools are being used today, like computer forensic work, special tools which are available to identify emails where the evidence is hidden from the thousands or lakhs of mails which are available. Identification of particular call which fraudster has made, which has an evidence. Technology is being used extensively to investigate frauds. It's important to appreciate that when a corporate fraud takes place, there is human element involved. And it's very dynamic, situation normally. What we actually see, therefore, is that it's not only important to have laws as a deterrent for fraud, but important to have a culture in a corporate which prevents fraud from happening, or that corporate culture or tone at the top or corporate governance, however we call it, is important from fraud prevention perspective. So only having law would not solve this issue of corporate frauds.